Assembly video of VORON 0.2 Pro. 1. Make sure the materials are complete before assembling. 2. Need to prepare a set of printed parts, or a set of machine parts. 3. Prepare auxiliary tools, such as screwdrivers, tweezers, small blades, etc. 4. The full video is long, please watch it patiently. Please give your valuable suggestions if you do not do well. First, according to the BOM, the profiles are distinguished and labeled. Number A quantity, 1. Number B quantity, 9. Number C quantity, 2. Number H quantity, 2. Number D quantity, 2. Number E quantity, 4. Number F quantity, 2. Number G quantity, 1. Number J quantity, 4. First take out two number E. Take out the rail holder. Take out two MGN7H rails, insert the wire rail holder into the empty surface of the profile. Use M2X6SHCS to lightly lock both ends of the MGN7H rail. Ensure that the track can move left and right. Take out a ruler and measure the distance from one end of the line rail to the edge of the profile at 38 mm, and lock and fix the line rail. Repeat last action. Take out the printed part, take out the M3X8BHCS and M3 nut, and lock it to fix the line rail. Take out two profile C, two wire rails and required wire rail holders. Refer to profile E-line rail installation. Take out the ruler and measure the distance of 33 mm to fix the line rail. Thank you. Take out the printed part, take out the M3X8BHCS and M3 nut, and lock it to fix the line rail. Take out two profiles B. Get 4XM3X6BHCS and 6XM3 nut ready. Preload 2M3 nut. Preload 4M3 nut. First install 2M3X6BHCS. Two M3X6BHCS installed on both sides. Twist M3X10BHCS on both ends of the profile. Fix the profile C with the line rail installed on the profile B through the M3X6BHCS, no need to determine the position. The direction from the line rail to the edge of the profile is upward. Each then preloaded with 3M3 nut. Fit another profile B. Take out profile H. Installed at both ends of profile B. Loosen the screws of profile C so that profile B is perpendicular to profile H. Refix profile C so that the distance to the left and right sides is 58 mm respectively. Check if profiles are perpendicular. Fix slider print with M3X8BHCS locking. Take out the heat bed support plate. Ready to print and soldering iron hot melt nut indenter. Press the M3 brass heatset inserts, shoot M3x5x4 into the print. Load the WIGO terminal and heatbed thermal adapter board into the print. Lock the adapter board with M3x6BHCS. Lock with M3x16BHCS. Lock the T8 screw nut print with M3x16BHCS. Remove both ends of the tank drag chain. Install this end, put the spare end on the other end. Find the printed part and lock the removed head with M3x16BHCS. Attach the heatbed support plate to the slider with M2x8SHCS. unscrew the two profile C screws. Slide the hotbed support plate up and down until it is smooth, and lock the screw at one end. Then slide the hotbed support plate up and down smoothly to the other end to lock the screw. After installing, continue to slide to check whether it is smooth. Not smooth enough, to continue to repeat the previous action until smooth. Find the Z-axis limit switch line. Lock the limit switch to the print with M2X10 self-tapping screws for plastic. Pay attention to the direction of the micro switch. Fixed mounted micro switch with M3X8BHCS. Check that the slider is just enough to trigger the switch. Put the rail slider fixing plug back into the rail. Remove profile H. preload 2 M3 nuts. Preload 1 M3 nuts. Preload 2 M3 nuts. Preload 2 M3 nuts. Take out profile E. Install the two profiled rails on the top. The other two are placed below. Find the M3X10BHCS, install one M3X10BHCS at both ends of each profile E. Installation profile H. Tighten the screws so that profile H is perpendicular to profile E. Adjust each profile. Install the other end of the tank drag chain. Install mid panel 3mm thick. Through the slot between two profiles. Preloaded M3 nut. 3 M3 nuts on the left and right, 4 M3 nuts on the bottom. Three M3 nuts on each side. Prepare one profile B. Screw on M3X10 BHCS on both ends. Preload 4 M3 nut. With M3 nut face down, take out profile D. With two holes facing down, locking screw. Check each face profile preloaded M3 nut.